still, this guy must be the world's greatest actor because I didn't even have a clue.
Yeah, I'll bet.
Listen, Brenda, I am so sorry for disappearing on you and Sonny in D.C. We just kind of got swept up in it, you know?
I know. Eddie kind of told me about it. It sounded so cool.
It was. Oh, this guy is one of a kind.
Yeah, he's full of surprises.
He is the greatest. And being Mrs. Eddie Main is the most wonderful thing that has ever happened.
The prospect of becoming Mrs. Ned Ashton makes me very happy.
Well, my mission in life is to make you happy.
And my mission is to prove to you that you have made the right decision. The smartest decision, in fact, that you'll ever make.
You've already done that.
Good. Then let's set a date.
And after the wedding, guess where we went?
I have no idea.
Coney Island. Well,
first we went and told my ma, and then we went to Coney for the honeymoon.
Ew, Coney Island. This is your dream honeymoon?
Yes! And then we ate cotton candy, and guess who caught the brass ring on the carousel?
You.
No, Eddie. Do you know what he said?
What?
Eddie. He caught the brass ring when he married me. Is this guy a romantic or what?
Gosh, well, this is definitely a new side of Eddie.
Oh, and you should have seen him going down on the cyclone. He was screaming the whole way down, and then he turned green. But he did it for me.
So what'd your parents say about this?
Oh, well, you know, Pop did his third degree routine, but Eddie passed with flying colors. And Ma's great about it. She just wants us to make it official sometimes.
Wait a minute, you mean it's not?
No, I mean like, you know, in a Catholic church with a priest and a nuptial mass and the whole thing, you know. And we're going to do that for her as soon as we can. And Brenda, when we do, how'd you like to be my maid of honor?
Me? Lois, what about your family?
Oh, well, Dee Dee and Noreen, they'll be bridesmaids, and Geraldine, too, if she wants. And Franny, well, if Franny ever returns to this planet, well, she's welcome to, you know, but she's usually totally unreachable. I'd like my best friend and my business partner to be my maid of honor.
Lois, I'd be honored. Thank you.
Of course.
Hey, you know what? I'm sorry that we missed the gig in D.C. Sonny and I got a little crazy.
Oh, well, he'll catch Eddie next time. Tell all.
Lois, let's stay on you and Eddie for a minute. What's next?
Well, I'm thinking it would make sense to set up both the record company and myself in Port Charles.
I'll get my own place. That way I'll be close to Eddie, but I still won't be crowding him.
Lois, you're married.
A two-household marriage?
I'm going to keep my place and he's going to keep his. We're going to see each other pretty much the same way we've been seeing each other.
Lois, is this okay with you? Whose idea is this?
Hey, whatever works, right? Look, I do not need a picket fence and a two-car garage to be happy. I mean, Eddie's still getting used to this whole new change with himself, and I want to give him the space to figure it out.
Oh, Lois, you are an amazing woman.
Aren't I?
Are you really okay with this?
You're sweet to worry. But I have never been better in my whole life. Eddie loves me. We're married. That's what counts, right?
Right. Hey, you know what? I'm happy for you.
Hey, and you know what? Let me know when it's time for us to go pick out those wedding dresses
you got your
tomorrow, okay?
Will do.
You know what? I gotta go, but I'm gonna call you back, okay? Bye.
Hey, AJ, what's up?
Haven't you heard? Ned is marrying Katherine.
You can't do that.
AJ, there is no way that Ned is marrying Katherine.
Boy, be careful there, Brenda. If I didn't know better, I'd think that maybe you're jealous.
I am not jealous. I have no interest in Ned except as a friend. I just couldn't imagine why he'd want to marry Katherine, of all people.
Yeah, well, it seems they've had this little courtship going on for quite some time. You didn't notice?
Well, I mean, I knew that Katherine was working for the hotel and that she and Ned were friends, but what, they're just suddenly thrown into some big romantic scene?
Ah, the wonders of love.
AJ, there is something else going on here, isn't there? There is, and I think you should tell me what it is.
No can do, Brenda. I mean, I don't know all the details. Well, even if I did, it's really not my place to...
That's fine. I'll just go talk to Ned about this. Because there's no way that he is doing this.
When. Since I imagine you'll be holding on to that incriminating evidence against Alan until after we tie our knot.
A fair assumption.
Then why not sooner rather than later? After all, June is the bridal month, isn't it?
Always a romantic.
There's also the matter of my family's peace of mind.
And so loyal. Do you mind me asking just what the terms were you struck with your family? I'd like to know just how important this marriage is to you.
Sure.
Let me guess. It has something to do with the ever-popular incinerator.
I get 1% of the company from each family member. A go-ahead on the incinerator project, and family voting rights on same for a period of 1 year.
Impressive.
Make hay while the sun shines.
Absolutely. Well, with your newfound hay, perhaps we should consider a prenuptial agreement.
What for?
I assume you'd like to protect yourself.
I'm hardly in a position to dictate terms. Besides, I think it's in the family's best interest to make you feel secure as a quartermate, like a full partner, both in the family and in the business.
I am more each minute.
Why waste the lawyer's time with a prenuptial?
No reason at all. I like the way you think.
I'm glad.
You know, I am so looking forward to being Mrs. Ned Ashton. Ned, do you think that we could announce our engagement to hospital benefits?
Welcome home, Ned. You two-timing, bigamist, creep, you have exactly 5 seconds to tell me exactly what the hell is going on.
First off, keep your voice down.
Well, AJ tells me that you and Katherine are engaged.
Please try to remember that you are one. Of the privilege, too. You know the whole truth. Please don't abuse that privilege.
You want to talk about abuse? You are married to Lois. And now you're going to marry Katherine?
I don't have to tell you anything.
Oh, I think that you do, or else I can just talk to everybody about
it, Ned.
All right,
shh. Okay. Here's the story. Listen carefully. First off, I love Lois. I married her in good faith, and I have no intention of hurting her.
Oh, right. Would you demonstrate by marrying another woman?
It's a simple case of blackmail, okay? Katherine has in her possession some evidence that could be very embarrassing to the Quartermains if it ever were made public.
Evidence? What are you... Evidence about what?
That's not important. What is important is her price. You see, her price for handing over this evidence to us is marriage to me.
So you have to pay the price. Guess what, Ned? You can't. You're married to Lois.
I know that. And now you know that. But Katherine doesn't have to know that. You see, I can go through with the ceremony, play along with this until I get the evidence back.
But what happens when this whole thing blows up in your face? Do you happen to know that there is a law against what you're doing in this state? You could end up in jail and break Lois's heart all in one shot. Look at yourself. Look at you. You are about to become the lowest of the low, and you are just standing here with this disgusting little smile on your face. You need to get a grip.
Brenda, I am in my element, so don't question what you don't understand.
Don't you condescend to me, or I will splash your sick little scheme all over this house.
You know, only you could put it that way. Don't you see? I'm the one who's making the sacrifice here.
Ah, right.
I don't want to marry Katherine, but I am, for the sake of the family.
Oh, please. You love it. You love living dangerously and controlling everyone. Don't try and tell me that you're a victim in this, because I don't buy it.
Okay. You're right. I do get off on it. But I wouldn't if I couldn't handle it so well.
Oh. Well, I am certainly glad to see that your ego is still fully inflated.
It doesn't hurt to have a little confidence. Now, so you don't worry about me going to jail, since I know that is your main concern, my welfare. I won't be facing charges if Katherine doesn't file a suit. And she won't be filing a suit if she doesn't find out. Or if I find something to hold over her head as insurance, which I will.
Right. Okay, so how can you be sure that something like that exists?
Well, this is Katherine's second major scam since she hit Port Charles. So I'm sure there's a few skeletons in her closet, and I intend to find them. But in the meantime, my main priority is to protect Lois from all of this.
So basically, you want your cake and eat it too.
Exactly. And I can do that. Can I count on you keeping your pretty mouth shut?
You are playing for awfully high stakes this time, Ned.
Is there any other kind?
Hello?
Hello, Mrs. Maine.
Hello, Mr. Maine.
And how is my lovely bride?
Missing you. When are you coming up to Buffalo?
Day after tomorrow.
Oh, kill me. That's a lifetime away.
I know. It can't be helped. Mr. Maine has a big social event tomorrow night at which he is required to make an appearance on behalf of the company. He would invite you, but it's going to be a total crashing bore.
Is blonde PR person going to be there?
Probably.
Then I suggest you get your ring size so you can display it prominently on your very taken finger.
Already done. I went to Hedwig's today. I'm wearing it now. It looks fantastic.
I can't believe I'm wearing your ring. I mean, we're not just going steady. We're actually married.
Yes, we are.
No regrets?
No regrets.
I love you so much, Eddie.
Lois, my love for you is greater than I ever imagined possible. You know, I used to wonder what the purpose of life was, you know? Why we're all here? Now I know. So we can have this one shot of feeling what I'm feeling for you. If I died tomorrow, I'd die a happy man.
Oh, Eddie.
What? I'm really, really sorry, but I have to go now.
Eddie?
It's an emergency. I'll call you. I know you.
I've come for you.
Well, I'm all yours.
I thought maybe you and I could go to dinner and show Edward my ring.
Well, that sounds good, but the family's not here, so I guess we'll have to wait till tomorrow.
At the ball. Well, I'll tell you, I was going to go shopping for dresses. Do you want to help me? Or maybe we should stay here until Annabelle interrupts.